Hello everyone, I'm Durgesh Sahani and we are going to create new series of video tutorials for advanced MySQL concepts in PHP. So this is the first session where we are going to see how to create foreign key in PHP MyAdmin, and in this whole series of video tutorials we are going to learn how to set up the foreign key and these actions: cascade, set null, no action and restrict. We'll understand these actions, joins, of course inner joins, outer joins, and this cross self join. Then we'll see how to create a view, how to use view, then stored procedures with parameter, without parameters, and how to use cursor in stored procedures and triggers. So these points we are going to cover in this whole series of video tutorials. Okay, so let's start now. First we have to go to the PHP MyAdmin and I'll show you what database we are going to use. So at my previous tutorials I have worked with this readers tables database, where I have two tables. One is authors, where we have some author details, and second one is books. So which books is belong to which authors, that details we have saved over here. So here we have author ID and book name published on. So see, so what is foreign key is, it's a primary key of parent table. Okay, so here you can see, here we have this ID, and this ID is nothing but the author ID, and we have to link it with this table author ID. Okay, so how to set up it? There are two ways actually you can set up these things, this foreign key. I'll show you both. And one more thing before setting this foreign key we have to remember is the field you want to set, like foreign key in any table. So both table should be on the storage engine of both table should be InnoDB. Okay, and second thing is the data type of your parent, whatever the parent ID or primary ID you have, that data type should be same in both the tables. Okay, so let's start now. You have to go to the child table first. Okay, and go to the structure, and here you will find one link, relation view. So you have to click on that. So here you have to create set up the foreign key. So from here, from this column, you can select author ID, and this is a database, and table you have to select, so authors. So if you have primary key, it will auto populate your ID. Okay, now you can leave it blank, it will create automatic. So if you want to create by SQL, so here you can see what SQL you need. So alter table books, add foreign key on author ID, reference table is authors, and we are trying to set up it with ID. On delete, on restrict, update. On delete also we have used this restrict, and on update restrict. So what is this means, I'll show you. So let's create it with restricts. So just click on this save button. Now you can see we have added foreign key. If you go to the, let me go here, and if you select these books and structure again, you can see this index key is added. Previously it was not there. Okay, on author ID. So we have set up the foreign key. Now what is meaning of restrict, right? So if you go here to the parent table, and if you try to delete, and let me show you some data. So here we have author ID 1, and we have some detail of that books for which belongs to author 1, and author 1 is Swami Vivekananda. So if you want to delete it, it will not allow to delete you. Let's see, because it have some references in this table. But if you go here and if you try to delete any record from here, it will allow to delete you. Okay, for example, I'm just going to delete author of 5, and I'm going to delete it. Okay, see, I'm able to delete it, but not from the parent tables. Okay, And now, what is the meaning of let me go here and structure again, relation view. From here you can delete it or update it. So see, we are going to make the change like cascade. So make both the changes cascade. Click on save. Now it is updated. So if I go here again, and if I'll try to delete it from here, so that record, so see, we have 5, author 5, and if you go here, so you can see from author 5, 4 books are here, right? So if you go and update it or delete it, so let me update it first. So if you are going to update it for, let's say 10, okay? So you have updated ID of 5 to 10. So if you go to the books table again, here you can see the ID get changed to 10. Okay, so this is what cascade. And if you delete this entry from here, if you try to delete it, it will delete from here as well as from child table. You can see the ID of book 10 get deleted. Okay, now we'll see. So I think you understand these two things, right? Cascade and restrict. Now if you go to this relationship view again, relation view again, and if you select from here, set null, and see no action is similar to this restrict. In some other DBMS or database servers, the meaning of this no action will be different, but here it have the same meaning. Only it will check all the prior conditions at first, and then it will perform all the actions. Okay, now set null. If you set null and just click on save button, so it get updated. Okay, so what it will do, see, we have author 4, and if I'm going here and just trying to delete this of author 4, deleted. Now if you go to the books table again, here you can see author 4 entry we have, but it gets set to null. And whenever make sure if you are going to update this constant to set null default action, so on the this author ID, the default value should be null. If you have not set it, it will not allow you to add this action on delete and on update set null. It will not allow to do it. Okay. Okay, and what is the second method? From here you can add this. So I'll show you that thing. So let's just delete it. Now we don't have any reference. If you go to the structure again, here you can see we have this index, but we don't have that relation view. Okay, so the second thing is you can select this database, and from more just click on this designer. So go to the designer, okay, and there you find one link, create relation. So just click on this and see, we have author tables. So ID is book, and set foreign key this author ID. So you can see here it is asking me what you want to do on delete and update. So I'm just going to say cascade and cascade. Okay, and you can change it on delete you want cascade, and in on update you want some more options. Okay, so you can do that. So just click on okay. Now you can see it is deleted, added. So this ID is reference to this. So this is the primary key and this is foreign key. If you go again to the structure and select these books, and if you go to the structure again and relation view, you can see one foreign key is created from here. Okay, so this is how there are two ways from where you can create a foreign key in phpMyAdmin. Okay, so I have explained you how to set up the foreign key and what are the meaning of cascade and restrict, no action, and set null. So in the next session, I'll show you how to use joins in PHP. Okay? So thank you very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.